Hey, what's going on? It's Kelly Betz with the No Coast Podcast here in Chicago at Pompey's House, joined with...
Hey, Jonny Storm.
You don't get the mic. It's mine. I learned that mistake with satire. He just started freestyling for 5 minutes.
It's like, you're not getting this back. It's all right.
I hear you might have plans to tour extensively, and what does that include, and how is that looking so far?
I'm going to do... a bunch of battle rap shit as far as that touring. I mean, I got the album done and I'm gonna push that one heavy, but I'm really focusing on maybe making this the last year I battle, just because it's, for me, it's approaching that cusp, like you said, the 10-year mark, and I don't want to battle more than that. You know what I'm saying? It's already like I've done enough. But so this year, you know, I've just lined up a bunch of them and I'm gonna do as many as I can and obviously rock some shows and shit and push the new project, but it's mainly like I'm gonna try to just wash my hands out of battle rap and then reinvent all that. Because, you know, it's hard to leave that stigma once you're in there.
Do you feel like, to me, I saw what you were doing is taking this kind of smaller scene stuff and pushing it. I mean, you got on World Star, and you're one of the first guys to just be known as an acapella written. I mean, like, in the whatever. I don't want to call it, like, nerd stuff. I mean, you know, with all due respect to what Smack DVD was doing, the joke acapella stuff, you're like the biggest name when that first blew up.
With your trailer trash verses, you would find it strange when that surfaced that your mom and your sister are the same exact person. Take it back further. Like when y'all ran out of squirrels and started making rat burgers. This ain't a battle. Y'all's taping axe murder. It's Texas Chainsaw. Once you 0-2 on grind time, just X your name off.
Do you feel like you're getting the right recognition as that person that you were almost a decade ago? Or do you think that some of that's been lost in the shuffles of the way people remember things?
I mean, I don't think I ever, even back then, I never really got that recognition as being like that. It was kind of living the moment. We didn't know that what we were doing was going to catch fire like that and everybody was going to join the fucking wave and it was going to be as big as it was. Obviously, we were just freestyle battlers, you know, it was like a first crack at something different. But I mean, so now I really don't even care, like, because it's... everybody comes from a different era, like you said. I mean, you know, Smack's been going on forever. I used to watch Smack DVDs before I was even rapping. So it's like just being a part of this generation now and how it and what battle rap is now is just cool to even have a foot in there.
Yeah, you know, you are part of the transition. Yeah. You know, how long were you battling before it became the YouTube leagues?
I was probably battling like, I want to say like 6 years. Heavy, just freestyle battles and, you know, entering every contest that there was and all the lounge battles or the Red Bull contest, you know, winning everything I could. It was, I didn't even think nothing more of it. It was like, you go in there with the chance to win money. You don't really go there for anything else but bragging rights. And now it's just, you get flown out. That right there is already beyond what it was, you know.
It's provided a lot of opportunities to a lot of people that I know. I think that's pretty, I'm happy to be a part of that and help instigate that. I wanted to ask what it was like. I think a really weird video in a weird circumstance, with so many battles on footage looking like the same thing. Something strange that you were involved in was battling Dizaster in a kind of freestyle situation, and then the crowd was like a little different. Could you talk about that and what was the context and what's your side of the story there and what was it like to live through that? Because it's one of my favorite videos of yours.
Yeah. That was a paid dues festival. It was the first time that battle rap got a major stage and a major festival. And we had the big octagon and shit. It was a real legit octagon. Like someone could have died in there fucking. And you know what I'm saying? And the crowd, you know, paid dues is like 40,000 people out there. So what came into our little thing was probably like 5,000 could squeeze in, and it was like wall to wall.
One of the best in the East. Y'all give it up for Jonny Storm. Here's Jonny.
Why in this bitch? You just a killer on Twitter, cause you are such a big bitch. He a racist that be hating with some terrorist pride. You just mad you have the same eyebrows as the dad from American Pie. Like an avatar, this bitch couldn't live on his own.
What's the difference between what do you see? I mean, like recording independently and you're trying to jump on the majors and dealing with major artists. Is there a difference, or is it just the same thing with a veil on top and we think it's all illustrious?
Yeah, I mean, and they're fans first and foremost. Most of them are fans and they watch it because it's just something that most of them don't have the balls to do, and they respect it, and they respect the craft of it, and they know battle rap is like literally saving their mainstream music, and that's why they're writing even harder. It's because they've been watching battlers and they know there's a standard that people are listening to outside of it. I mean, music is just a different monster because you can make a music without even any type of structure or no wits at all, and it can still sell a million copies, which is far greater than 10 million views of a battle. You know what I'm saying? Like 100,000 copies sold to shitting on a battle. Like if I could just transition those fans, it'd have been a whole nother world. And it's like you said, it's just two different worlds. It's music is a far greater world, and the mainstream artists know it, but it's just funny because it's like also they're in the moment and they don't even realize that we look at them like up there and they look at battlers the same way, kind of like a athlete would look at a musician and shit, and then the musician wants to be like an athlete. The only difference is we just want their money. All of it.
I'm a stagehand. I've worked for those guys. It's not that comfortable for them either. Just so you know, that's why they look at the battle rappers that way. It's, you know, they're eating craft meals and whatever, living on a bus. So just if that makes you feel any better, man, so happy to have you out here again. Hopefully it's not the last time before you're done. And it's going to be a hell of an event tonight. And thanks for sitting down with me, man.
Thank you, good sir.
Where can I check out your music?
Oh, Shotaville.com. I mean, you could go to iTunes or just Google Jonny Storm and you'll find the forecast and, you know, Joel Ortiz and Terminology and Freeway on it. But my new shit is Arnold Palmer's, and you only get it on Shotaville.com. And I got a lot of dope battlers that I fucks with out there. You know, Fredo, Lou Cypher, Frank Stacks. And I could name drop forever, but just know that shit is just as heartfelt. So look it up.
Yeah, man. Thank you so much again. See ya. No coast.